Okay, good evening everyone. I hope everyone's alright. I'll just share with you this new addition to my steam iron collection that I got. I actually got it for free today because a lot of people... Hang on, just turn it around so you'll be able to see what it is. Just want to continue as well. My newest way of doing videos, I always think it's quite nice, it's a unique way, to have some vinyl playing in the background, so I'm playing the Supremes on this one. Make sure I've not done it too loud so you can still hear me. But anyway, it's just a new way of, you know, got something unique. For those who tune into this channel and obviously pay for Motown as well, you can enjoy this a bit as well. Should be too loud to get a copyright thing on it though. Anyway, as I was saying, those of you who know that I do voluntary work twice a week at British Heart Foundation in West Ealing, this iron came in this morning and it was, just want to get a good view of it, it was perfectly working. I plugged it in because my responsibility is to plug it in and then to check that it works fine. Then if not, then if it does, this is what I do, you can actually see it here. So I have to put my name, the date it was tested and the store code, and this is to certify that it has been worked. It's been tested. It gets put on the shelf and then the man who comes to do the electrical PAT testing comes in the next day. He'll probably be there tomorrow actually. I brought the sign in and I tested it, it worked fine. Now, the guy, one of my assistants said to me, we're not selling that because apparently it's too scratched. Now I will admit it does have some scratches. So he said to me, we'll throw it out. And I thought, well, there's no way I'm letting that iron go. You know, it's a classic one. I mean, I'm sure it looks like 80s, 90s. And it's working fine, it looks lovely. And of course, I haven't explained exactly what model it is. It's a Rowenta Professional Inox, model DE81.1C. Yeah, I got it right, made in Germany. Now, Rowenta are my favourite brand of irons. Not exactly my favourite model, but the favourite one I own so far. Because you can see in the background there is my Philips GC1433-40 iron, the only other iron I have. So I got this for free. Now that one I paid £16 for. I also got to mention down there I got an extractor fan from there, an airflow one. So this one, you know, I saw it and I thought, I've got to have this. So I was allowed to put it in the bag and take it home as well as I got some old earphones that someone left behind. You know, just some ones that I found that were really good. But anyway, I thought I'd just do... my favourite song come on there. I mean, I've cleaned this iron and everything. And my God, I am so impressed with it. Because... something tells me it's more of an industrial iron because of the way it fires steam out. I mean, I know Rowenta are good though for their steam generators and the pressure that steam comes out in. So just have a quick overview of it. One thing that got me on this was this clear tank. And it is heavy because of this stainless steel. You can see some scratches in that, I suppose, can't you? That's where you put your water in. It's not got a cover. Either it's missing it or... I don't know, your steam button and your water jet. Oh, there's still some water in there. And it's your steam control. It does stick quite a lot though. Your indicator light and your heat selector. Rowenta Professional Inox. And even it's all written in German on the back. And what we're gonna do, we're gonna fill her up. And then I'll do a demonstration for you. That line always gets to me, it does. You might be able to see it, hang on. I mean, I know some people might not like the fact I got music playing, but it's actually helped me feel more confident on camera. Because normally, as you know, I get quite nervous on camera, so it's helping me in a way. As I said, if people don't like it, they have got the choice not to watch my videos. But I like doing it this way. That's what we're playing at the moment. There's my airflow extractor fan. I'm glad I got this table. Where have I put my one? Oh! This version doesn't have the vocal where it goes, I'm so glad. Oh my god. It's taking a long time to go down. Oh, that's why you've got to tilt it forward. Right, in that case. Might as well fill her up to max or however much I can get out. I just want it, I'm in love again. Right. I've actually, I've slightly overfilled that. It reminds me very much of this iron I used to have when I was little. It was a steam generator one. But it had this. I've never been able to figure out which one it is. One thing I'll say about Rowenta. What I love is their precision tip. And only that and around is the holes. All that is just for show. There's your information. Made in Germany. It's very good. Rowenta. They're my favourite brand. Right. Should get this ironing board out and then we'll see. Now I'm going to switch the iron on. And we'll just be naughty in this one, I'll turn it right up. Oh, we're just in time. Switch the friggin' thing on. The plug. There you can see the light. And the gauge is heating up. Like there's some steam coming out. Might as well iron my new shirt that I got today. This is actually how I do my irons, because I have the Supremes playing. Okay, not just the Supremes then, it's like Motown in general. Oh, that smell, I love the smell of irons when they get hot. Well, this is my new shirt with... You see that? Detroit, the home of Motown. You might be able to pick it up, I don't know if... Oh, she's heating up. Do my ironing beforehand at night. I've got the ironing board slightly lower as well. I never have it this low. Ready? There we go. It's the first thing she's properly ironed actually. Oh, so smooth. It just glides. Look, it just glides. Oh, I think it's that smell of a burning oil. Nice precision tip. I love that precision. I love the view of an iron. Look, like a train. Ready? You ready to see the steam function now? God, if I shoot it that way, you're... Oh God, it's... Oh God, hang on. It seems if it's steamed up the lens. Can you see it? Smoking at the end there. Oh God, like, sorry about that bloody lens flare now. Actually, hang on. I don't want that. Oh god. It's made it go out of focus. Yay, one of my favourites playing now. Actually, should I have that switched off that lamp? Alright, so let's keep going. She's just steaming the place out. Just go over this bit one more time. So I was actually ironing something twice just so I can iron more than once. It's so smooth the way that is gliding. Can you just push it? Look. Ready? Watch out. If I shoot it that way, you'll see. As I said, everyone does their ironing their own way, so I would highly appreciate no comments on how I do my ironing. Not that anyone has, but I'm just saying. Oh, and our wires could be gliding as well because of the texture of this new shirt. Never been washed or anything. Oh, it smells so good. I have a thing for the weirdest smells. After I do this video, I like to burn incense sticks. I've got a thing for incense sticks. But not the kind that have fragrances, I mean the kind that like you smell in a lot of Asian shops. Not being racist or anything there, but it's the one, like the one to you, I think they burn at Diwali or something. I think it's burned across Asia. Because you always smell it when you go into a lot of international shops. There was also, for those who follow me on Facebook with me, there was two other irons that I bought in a brand new Ruffle Hop Steam Glide, a Morphe Richards Blue Comfy Grip, and that's actually a Remington Travel Iron. Ooh. It's like the Flying Scotsman. The Flying Dutchman, actually. Well, I don't know what German steam train. I'll tell you what, that is really ironed well, that shirt. For those probably wanting to know what CD vinyl I'm playing this one, the 25th anniversary. That's got Diana Mary and Florence on it. The actual cover has got Cindy Birdsong on it. Trying to see that move. Right, I shall iron something else just for your viewing pleasure. Try and iron something different material. Let's see what else I can iron. I thought I'd just this last towel, I've actually wet it a bit to see how it does it. See, I'm just finding anything I can to iron now. What if I shine a there's something interesting I might do quickly. Oh, Rowenta in the spotlight. Right, what happens if I shut off all the lights in my ironing in the dark. Let's just see how it works. Oh, this is really good. The camera's set to pick up speed, like fast action. Let's just steam the hell out of this. Is it done the lens and you just keep me hanging on. I'm gonna iron the hell out of this. It's a really, really good iron though. If anyone can figure out when this is actually from, I would highly, you know, I'd be so happy if someone could find that, but I'm gonna guess. Late 80s, 90s, early 90s. It could be late 90s. But one thing, Rowenta have kept this shape up though, because on the newer Steam Force and Steam Focus ones, the DW range. Okay, just to end this video, I'm going to end it there. I want us to say quickly, hang on. Thank you so much for watching. It means the world to me you're watching my videos, especially because they're not all about normal things. Hopefully tomorrow there might be another washing machine I can test. I'm not going to promise that, but could have another iron. I hope you appreciate the Supremes being in the background as well. And just to say goodbye. Goodbye.